Right after we were wed, husband, you sent out on a journey. How was I to tell you how I felt, wandering around a foreign country? When will you ever come home? The Japanese, like many other immigrants, came to the United States seeking fortune. Their immigration began as early as 1843. At first, they were welcomed as a cheap labor source working on farms and railroad construction. The Gentlemen's Agreement of 1907 later curtailed immigration for male laborers but left the door open for women, many of which came as picture wives through arranged marriages. Eventually, Japanese immigrants settled in communities supported by their own businesses and worked to achieve the American dream. In early 1941, the American public, much of which was still in the midst of economic depression, resolved to isolate themselves from the looming conflict halfway around the world. While Europe is in the middle of its Second World War, Americans are distracted by swing music and escape to the world of Hollywood, with movies like Sergeant York, Casablanca, The Great Dictator, and Buck's Private.
Came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowin' reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam.
The bombing of Pearl Harbor, however, shocked the American people and revived the people's sense of patriotism. Along with it came panic, aggression, and a deep hunger for revenge. Though many Japanese living in the United States were Nisei, or American-born citizens, they were immediately viewed as cohorts of the enemy. Sadly, Japanese Americans became targets of hatred and anti-Japanese campaigns. The War Department, for example, declared all Japanese American men as enemy aliens. Many prominent government officials spoke out against Japanese Americans.
I am for the immediate removal of every Japanese on the West Coast to a point deep in the interior. And I don't mean a nice part of the interior, either. Just herd 'em up, pack 'em off, and give 'em the inside room of the Badlands. Let 'em be pinched, hurt, hungry, and dead up against it. Personally, I hate the Japanese, and that goes for all of them. Henry McLemore, 1942.
Dr. Seuss, who is best known for his collection of children's books, started as a political cartoonist and commented on the war from 1941 to 1943.
We're gonna have to slap the dirty little Jap, and Uncle Sam's the guy who can do it. We'll skin that streak of yellow from the sneaky little...
Life magazine even printed an article entitled, How to Tell Your Friends from the Japs.
We'll cross her to the old woodshed. We'll start right on his bottom and we'll go to his head.
Virtually all Japanese are short. Japanese are likely to be stockier and broader hipped than short Chinese. Japanese are seldom fat, as they often dry up and grow lean as they age. Although both have the typical epigastric fold on the upper eyelid, Japanese eyes are usually set closer together. The Chinese expression is likely to be more placid, kindly, and open, while the Japanese are more positive, dogmatic, and arrogant. The Japanese are hesitant, they're nervous in conversation, and they laugh loudly at the wrong time. Japanese walk stiffly erect and hard-heeled. Chinese are more relaxed, have an easy gait, and sometimes shuffle. Time Magazine, December 1941.
On February 19, 1942, President Roosevelt signed Executive Order 9066, which authorized the mass removal of people with Japanese ancestry.
In time of national peril, any reasonable doubt must be resolved in favor of action to preserve the national safety, not for the purpose of punishing those whose liberty may be temporarily affected by such action, but for the purpose of protecting the freedom of the nation, which may be long impaired, if not permanently lost, by non-action.
First, Japanese Americans were ordered to register for the internment camps. Next, they were labeled and later transported by train to several locations throughout the West.
I'll bet your darling I'll go to your room. Sorry for what you've done. I'll bet your darling that you went to work for that old rising sun. A knife into the USA. You forgot what they learned you at UCLA.
Japanese entrepreneurs had to abandon their businesses as well as their homes. They were instructed to leave behind all but those few belongings that could be carried. Some were given as little as 48 hours to get rid of all of their possessions and be ready for the move. Today, their losses have been estimated in the billions.
Uncle Sam's a man who's given a helping hand to many a foreign land, don't forget it. But when somebody goes to tromping on his toes, they'd better guard their nose or they'll regret it. We're gonna have to slap the dirty little Jap, and Uncle Sam's the guy who can do it. The Japs and all their hooey will be changed into chop suey, and the rising sun will set when we get through it.
Japanese Americans sent to the camps were from all walks of life, from the very poor to the well-to-do. But once in the camps, they lived communally in squalid conditions. A resident expended advice to a friend not yet in the camps. Each apartment is a single bare room, with no furniture or shelving of any kind except a single army cot, one for each member of the family, a trash burner, and one light outlet. As there will be no privacy for the individual members of the family, suggest that curtain and large cloth material be brought to hang and screen off portions of the room. Bill Mimbu, May 1942. Residents could work, but work poorly compensated. They worked at jobs ranging from skilled to unskilled labor. Some even worked to support the war effort with propaganda posters. The worst injustice had to be the denial of civil rights. The compounds were surrounded by barbed wire and towers that housed armed guards. Strict rules that regulated everyday life were imposed. There were roll calls, curfews, and set meal times. Privacy was lost as camp authorities were allowed to make surprise visits and confiscate unauthorized material, such as cameras. Though Christian churches were built, the practice of Shinto was strictly forbidden. Even their movements from one part of the camp to another were closely monitored with access passes. In December 1944, the government announced an end of internment camps, and by March 1946, the last of the compounds were closed. Japanese Americans attempted to pick up where they left off, but it was immediately apparent discrimination had not disappeared. Clearly, it would persist as a means to maintain social injustice.